एनसीबी सोर्सेज से 500 ग्राम्स ऑफ मैरिजुआना वाज शिफ्टेड टू रियाज हाउस ड्यूरिंग द लॉकडाउन एंड कुरियर बॉय हैज रिवील्ड दैट दीपेश गॉट इट डिलीवर्ड एंड शौविक वाज द वन हु रिसीव्ड द ड्रग्स. Bhavtosh has details on this particular input as well. 500 grams of marijuana were shifted to Riya's house during the lockdown. Bhavtosh, the NCB has also now stumbled upon the information that the courier boy has revealed to them. Deepesh was the one who delivered it and Shovik received the drugs.
Yes, Swati. In fact, when Riha Chakravarti and others were questioned, it was found that Sushant Singh Rajput during lockdown wanted to spend some time at Riha's place, and subsequently, because of very strict enforcement of lockdown during that period, there was panic among all of them, and they decided to hire a.
Okay, we seem to have lost the connection with Bhavtosh, but. Okay, Bhavtosh, you're back. Please continue.
In a packet, and then subsequently put some household items into it. Deepesh called up the courier company. The delivery boy came, picked up the packet, and then within hours delivered it to Shovik at Riha's place. Now the courier boy has in fact been examined by the NCB last week itself. He has positively identified two persons. One of them is Shovik, and the other is Deepesh Sawant.
All right, Bhavtosh, thank you very much for joining us with those details. We're moving on now. As far as today's development in the case is concerned, the order copy is still awaited. Remember, the Sessions Court today earlier rejected the bail plea of Riya Chakravarti and five other accused in the Sessions Court. We have Tamal joining us on the broadcast at this point in time. We also have Mohit Sharma and Mohit Bhatt. Let's first go across to Tamal. Tamal, we're now being told that, of course, details are still awaited. And now only on Monday or sometime next week, the accused will have to approach the High Court for relief from there.
Well, Swati, at 1 in the afternoon, all the lawyers of the defense of the accused were called along with the special prosecutor of the NCB, and the order was discussed with all of them. However, they have not been served with the order copy. It's still in the making. They have given the Roznama basis of what they can now move their application, if they choose to do, before the Bombay High Court, once again for the bail application. So the Roznama has been given to them, that has the case details, that has the order details. However, the order per se has not been given to them because it's still under making. We know, as a matter of fact, the operative part of the order was told to the defense lawyers, and it was communicated to them without any ambiguity that all the bail applications, including that of Riya Chakravarti, Shovik Chakravarti, have been rejected. Having spoken to the special prosecutor of the NCB, he's told Times Now that it also goes on to highlight that the court had found merit in the evidences put forth by the NCB before the court so far. Mm-hmm. That also includes the testimonies, the statements given by all the accused. Mind it, all the accused had tried retracting those statements, suggesting that those statements were taken under pressure. However, NCB maintains that those statements had been given out to them voluntarily, mind the word voluntarily, and the court has found merit in that argument. So their bail applications have been rejected. Hmm. The option only before them now is to move to Bombay High Court. If they file an application today, it would be all online. If they file an application today or tomorrow, there is a possibility of the matter coming up before the Bombay High Court on Monday. Hmm. If not, then another application will be filed for the subsequent Thursday next week.
All right. Tamal, stay on with us. Before I go across to Mohit Bhatt and Mohit Sharma, let's play out the reactions.
कोर्ट में क्या बताइए?
आज सबके सब रिजेक्शन रिजेक्ट हो गए हैं. डिटेल ऑर्डर्स सोमवार को या मंगलवार को मिलेगी.
वजह क्या बताइए? ग्राउंड कैसे खा गया?
अभी वही डिटेल ऑर्डर आपको सोमवार को या मंगलवार को पता चलेगी.
सर, अभी डिटेल ऑर्डर हमको मिला नहीं है. सर,
जज ने क्या कहा?
जज ने कुछ नहीं कहा. कि जज ने इतने क्या, जितने भी अक्यूज है उनका बेल एप्लीकेशन रिजेक्ट किया, और बहुत ही इनिशियल स्टेज के ऊपर बेल एप्लीकेशन हुआ. ये रीज़न हमको समझ में आया. बाकी ऑर्डर मिलने के बाद सर हम आपको डिटेल लेंगे. सेक्शन 27 ने हमारे लिए काफ़ी यानी उसमें मुश्किल पैदा कर दिया बेल के लिए. सर,
आप हाई कोर्ट कब मूव करेंगे?
आज ही जैसे ही एप्लीकेशन, ये ऑर्डर, बेल एप्लीकेशन का ऑर्डर अपलोड हो जाता है, अपलोड की कॉपी ऑनलाइन निकाल के हमारा बेल एप्लीकेशन रेडी है, और हम तुरंत आज ही बेल एप्लीकेशन जैद विलात्रा का हाईकोर्ट में दाखिल करेंगे.
Right, let's go across to Mohit Sharma now. Mohit, the NCB had told the court that a bail at this stage of the investigation could hamper, could derail the investigation. Looks like the court did take a note of that fact.
Well, absolutely. And Swati, it really wasn't restricted to, the oral statements being given by the NCB, in which they had categorically mentioned that how giving bail would not just hamper the investigation, but at the same time, the eyewitnesses and the accused can, for that matter, also try to, destroy evidences as well. Now, as a matter of fact, some of the evidences which have been presented by the NCB were in a clearly showcased how there was absolute presence of those arrested in drug peddling cases. The CDR and the triangulation of cell network is something that the NCB depended on ensuring and producing in front of the court proper documentation as to how the location of many of them were triangulated, just to ensure and showcase the session court that all of them were in the know-how and the entire nexus and how it was really working. At the same time, the procurement of drugs and the seizures which have happened have also happened based on the statements of those arrested, and that was another point which was countered by the NCB to that which was presented by the counsels of those arrested. The counsels of those seeking bail had in fact argued that since there was not a huge quantity of drugs which was found on them during various raids conducted by the NCB, they must let go.
Flat in the court, given the fact that the court has rejected the bail application. Let me also go across to Mohit. But Mohit, as Zaid Bilathra's lawyer was saying, the stringent Section 27A and 29 made it extremely difficult to secure bail.
Well, yes, and you see, the NCB from the starting has been saying that if all these people will be given bail, then they may hamper the investigation. And we know for a fact that how NCB is saying that these people, all those who have been arrested, they have given them separate information. They have given them specific information that how this cartel in Bollywood is running. So if they get bail, then they might hamper that investigation. And because we know for a fact that how NCB is looking at that particular angle also. And know today, as our senior editor Bhaktos Singh was telling us, that NCB has prepared a list of certain celebrities and certain drug peddlers through which the whole cartel is running in the Bollywood. Now, these celebrities, what they used to do, they used to take drugs from all these peddlers and they used to distribute them to the other celebrities. So if you want to unearth the whole nexus, these people will have to stay in jail if they come out, and then they can hamper the proceedings. And that is why NCB has put stringent sections on them. So clearly, till 22nd, the hearing is being deferred. They have been sent to the custody. We have to wait and watch when exactly they will be moving to the Bombay High Court. As Tamal was saying, that it's either on Monday or on Thursday, because Bombay High Court is operating on 2 days only. So yes, stringent actions sections have been imposed on them.
Absolutely.
And NCB from the starting has been saying that if they come out, they will temper the evidence.
Absolutely. Mohit Bhatt, Mohit Sharma and Tamal, thank you very much for joining us with those details.